Nobody plays guitar like this guy.
Hey, are you ready to learn how to put wow factor into What Might Have Been by Little Texas? This is a great song, and I just love playing it over and over again. You're going to love it, and it's got a really cool little intro to it, too. So, you know what? In fact, let me just play this intro for you, because I like playing it so much. Maybe you'll remember what this song is. This is cool. Listen to this little lick. Is that not cool? I just love playing that. Hey, you want to learn it? Get your pick, get your guitar, and meet me in the studio. All right, let me show you the chords that we've got in here now. I'll put the chord diagrams up there for you. You've got a G chord. You've got a D4/F#. And what you're doing there, it might be easier for you. I'm going to put the chord diagram up there for you. It's actually played like this. If it's easier, you might want to just play a D. You can go ahead and play a D chord and use your thumb to pick up that F# bass on there. But it really sounds good if you can leave that G open, that third string open. You've got a C with a G bass, and all that is a C chord, but you're picking up that third fret on the sixth string with your ring finger. Trying to get all those bass notes in there. If you're a beginner and you can't do those bass notes and you can't do the thumb, don't worry about it. Just play the chords that I'm showing you. Just play a regular G, play a D, and play a C, and you'll be fine. You've also got a G minor, and you're going to have to play a bar chord on this one. There's another G minor you can play if you want to play it like that, but it doesn't sound as good. If you play the G minor like this, don't play this top string. Okay, just pick 5, 4, 3, and 2. But if you're a beginner, you want to practice doing that bar chord. There's your G minor. And you've got an A minor. You've got a G with a B bass, and all you're doing there, excuse me, all you're doing there is you're doing a walk up, and that's what that G bass does. Walking up to your C chord, so you've got an A minor, you're playing that A open. The G bass, all you need to do is take your middle finger, put it on that second fret of that fifth string, and your pinky on the third fret of the second string. And just pick that ring finger up. That's a G with a B bass. You've got an E minor and a B minor. And you can come back and reference all of these chord diagrams if you need to during a song. And you've got a D suspended and a D. You have an A minor 7, a B minor 7. And those chords right there, that's all the chords that you're going to have. That A minor and that B minor is just used at the very end, so you don't have to use those a lot. Anyway, that's all your chords. Now let me show you how to do that intro. Okay, let me show you how to do that intro now. I'm going to play it for you one time, and then I'm going to show you. That intro goes like this. If you're a beginner, this intro is pretty tough. This is a tough one for me to play just because it's so quick on playing the strumming and all. So if you're a beginner, you may want to just do the chords on that, okay? And I'll show you that some chords. You can just use a G, C, C minor, and G for your beginning. If you're going to try and put that wow factor into it, let me show you what we're going to do. Let me play this first lick for one time, and then I'm going to show you, and I'll put some tabs on there for you. Whoops. That's real important right there. The first thing that you're doing is you're hitting that second string, third fret, and you've got your pinky there. Your ring finger is on the third fret of that sixth string, and you're going to go. Okay, let me show you how to do the verses now. You're going to start off with a G. You've got a D4 with that F# bass. And it might be easier to go ahead and form it with your D and then just take that index finger off. You got a C with a G, because you want to get that bass note in there. A G minor and a G. So let's do that again.